y'all. Surfing Sapolopolous, aka Greek Texan, here today. Gonna make a classic dish from the old country. South Texas Kakavia, aka fish stew. I fish a lot. I'm a Greek fisherman, you know. And I have different ways to cook the fish that we catch down here in the Gulf of Mexico. We could either fry it, can bake it, can smoke it, can make soup, can make ceviche. There's a number of ways to cook the fish. But today we're gonna make kakavia, Greek fish stew. So, like I always say, or do I say it? Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. We should get started soon. And over here, I'm gonna show you some stuff. Kind of blanked out for a minute. I'm not really sure what I was doing. Started thinking about my remote control here, and I had to look at the buttons, which one stops the camera. Just to be honest with you. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Okay, right here we have three nice sized pompanos here. They're caught just last week, probably 4 days ago, okay? They've already been gut and gilled. I had them frozen. I'll fillet them. You don't need to watch that. I'm going to fillet them out. Take the bones out. We'll dice those up into nice chunks of meat to throw into this kakavia. Alright. Now over here we have the ingredients, the vegetables of the kakavia. 4 regular tomatoes. 3 carrots or snowman noses. Garlic, I'm not going to put all this, just 2 cloves, 3 medium onions, 4 good sized potatoes, olive oil, vegetable broth, and this is just for later, lemon pepper grinder. I'm going to make a sauce for it, a lemony sauce. Oh, and also whatever I did with it. Oh, it's way over there. This is a special, I'm not cooking conventional today, but this is a cream of shrimp. Cream of shrimp Campbell's. It's great for cooking. I don't know what else I would use it for. But this is cream of shrimp, know-how, and that's gonna go in the sauce also. So let me chop all this up and get the fish ready and we'll go from there. I don't wanna waste too much valuable time. Okay, folks. All right, we've got everything chopped up for here. Let's see, we got you. Right here, we got the potatoes, carrots, garlic. Over here, we got tomatoes, onion. I forgot to tell you, 4 stalks of celery there on the bottom. We're gonna start with this stuff first. So let's go over here. Don't mind the cake next to the pan. It's a cake being made. Get you some olive oil. Olive oil, remember? Put about a cup. Like that. It's okay. It's olive oil. It's good for you. Turn your burner on high. Okay. You're going to throw in stuff like potatoes. All the potatoes. Put a little garlic in there to give it some flavor. It's all gonna get to know each other. Some more potatoes. How about some carrots? More carrots and potatoes. And then the rest of the potatoes. Okay. What you're gonna do is you're gonna cook this a little bit. Not cook it all the way through. Just let the garlic cook down there. And just turn this around and kind of saute them. And then we'll add the rest of the ingredients. So, be right back. See when it starts, here, starting to saute and fry, you just take 2 of these wooden spoons, just move them all around, something like that. You're just sealing the goodness in. Whatever. You don't really even have to do this, but I'm doing it no-how. Trying to give it a little burnt, not burnt, but brown tinge to it. instead of just throwing it in a stock and boiling it, I'm gonna kind of seal the flavors into the veggies. All right, carry on. All right, sauteed it quite a bit. Take your, I just got organic vegetable broth, big deal. Pour it in. Let it do its thing. Oh, do you want to know how much this is? It's 32 ounces. Okay, 32 ounces. So let them all sit in there. Scrape them off the bottom if they're stuck. Bring this back to a burl. And then start cleaning the fish. I'm pretty sure I showed y'all how to do this, but I'm gonna do one know-how. Get your fish. This is Pompano. Put the knife under chair. Come around the fin and just start on the backbone. Come around. Hope I didn't mess up. Which I did. Never mind. This thing's so sharp it cut right through the backbone. Anyway, I gotta improvise now. Dang it. I went over the backbone. Oh, dang it. Hold on. I'll be here and I'll get back with the program here in a minute. There we go. I found the backbone again. That's what I was looking for, that backbone right there. And you just cut it off. I'm gonna go over these rib cage today. I don't want any bones in this. Then I just take it like this, hold this, and just come on here. So. This doesn't really matter. Whatever, you don't have to get it off. Anyway, there's the piece right here. It's got a couple bones in there yet. Then you just slice it down the middle. And get the knife like this. And I just fillet it. There you go, fish, skin. That little bloodline right there, you're gonna go ahead and cut that off too. There. What we're gonna do is take these and put them in nice bite-sized pieces, about like that. You want a piece about like that, it'll fit into a spoon. Alrighty, y'all get the point now. I'll say I never showed you. All right, folks. We've got chair. It's been about 25 minutes of simmering, boiling. Don't want to overcook it now. Tomatoes. And now we're going to dump in the rest. All the other goodies. There we go. Get them all in there. We won't want to waste anything. Everything costs money. Alright. Continue to cook this down. Stir these down a little bit. It's going to be a thick soup stew. You might have to bring it back up a little bit to get it to a burl. It'll burl soon enough. Veggies are about 98.9% water. So let's go ahead and burl that down. See what we got right here. There you go. We're going to burl that down for another 10 minutes, let's say, till the onions get translucent. Whatever, 10-15 minutes, all right? All right, we're gonna make some lemon sauce now. What I got here is an egg. I'm actually gonna get another egg, so I wanna make it nice and creamy, eggy. There's two eggs. Two eggs in there. What this is squeezed lemons. About, I got key limes or key lemons, whatever you want to call them, Mexican lemons. That's about, that was about probably eight of those little ones. Probably one big one or two big ones would be good enough. Okay, now stick this in here and just get your hand over it so it doesn't go crazy. Something like that. I don't like this thing. Let me get something bigger. This pit disrupting me. Hold on. Sorry, folks, for the interruption. But this is real. This isn't scripted. This is real, and things happen. You know how life is. All right. Now it might not splash as bad, and it might also. Notice the technique. The egg beater. Oh yeah, egg beater. Alright, you do that. Then what you do, you get a ladle of some sort. And you don't pour that right in the soup or you'll have egg drop soup. So you get you some warm broth out of the soup. You add a little bit in there, maybe a little bit more. It's alright if you get some of the onions, it's okay. Now what that'll do, I forget the name of this, but that'll get this to be a good temperature. And you do it like one more time. It's to allow the this to become a warmer temperature, than put cold in there. You just get egg drop soup. We're not shooting for egg drop soup. We're shooting for South Texas Kakavia. All right. Accidents do happen. That wasn't an accident. Okay, that's your basic Greek lemon sauce. Now we're going to bump it up to South Texas style with our cream of shrimp. Get your spoon. Kind of scoop that up in there. Gots to have the cream of shrimp, man. You could actually put this on most anything, man. What the Cajuns feed their little babies. Here, Boudreaux, have a bite. This is Cajun baby food, see? Don't miss a bite. Same thing. Bring that down there. Same thing. That's our cream. We add that a little bit. So now we'll go back over here. See what we got. We got soup cooking down. See that? As soon as those onions turn translucent, then we're gonna add the fish and the cream. We're almost done, folks. Almost done. Alright. They're not completely cooked, but that's okay. Now we're going to take our cream, pour it in. Cream, lemon, egg mixture. Kind of mix it in. Let it get to know each other. Might try to do the egg drop soup thing, but that's okay. Is that beautiful? Lovely? Mm-mm. It's like Grandpa used to make. Now, the fish. Let's drop your pieces of pomp in. Drop them in all over. This will cook so fast. It just more or less cook. It'll cook in the heat of the soup. You don't want to boil it now. No more boiling. The boiling's over, folks. Pretty much now, all we're doing is just cooking the fish. It's the last step. Put them down in there. Don't push them too hard. You don't want them to break apart. Just kind of let everybody get to know each other. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Kakavia, Greek, South Texas. Mmm. House smells lovely right now. Alright. You're going to bring this to a low simmer. Just put the top on there. It might start frothing, so keep an eye on it. We'll be back, and it should be ready to cool off, and we'll eat it. Alright, folks. We've got here is the Kakavia. I'm going to add some black pepper. I already put some of the lemon pepper in the sauce, but we're adding black pepper now. And I tasted it. I forgot to tell you, get you some sea salt. This is World Market sea salt. Put a little bit of sea salt. Not too much. Folks can always add some later. There you go. So let it get to know each other again. We'll kind of stir down the pepper and the salt. Let it. Don't want to stir this too hard and break the fish up. That's the problem we don't want. You can move it around like this. Slow. Alright. That salt will work down in there. Alright. Give it another couple minutes. We'll be ready. Test it out. Alright. One for my wife and one for me here. So the Kakavia. See the chunks of pomp in there? Got your potatoes, tomatoes, carrots, celery, onion, garlic's in there somewhere with this creamy, creamy, beautiful, lemony, eggy, shrimpy sauce. This stuff is good. It literally rocks. But we're going to have to let it cool off, because I don't feel like burning my palate right now. So once it cools off, we'll take a taste test. And I'll tell you good folks how much I appreciate you watching and commenting and all that good stuff. And then we'll carry on. And we'll think about what we're going to do next time. Alright, I'll see you in a bit. Alright folks, I'm trying a different view. I'm looking up at y'all, okay? I'm a little guy now. I'm little anyway. This time, I'm big this way. Alright, let's get the Kakavia. This is a Kakavia. See it? You saw it earlier, you're gonna see it again. Very hot still. Let's just get a piece of fish right off the bat. Quit playing around. A little piece of pomp right here. A little scoop of the soup. Creamy. Lemony. And so healthy. Oh God. It's good for you. Mmm. Opa. And that's good. That's good. Good, 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 good. I'm glad I'm Greek, man. That's all I can say. And I ain't Greek for a week. I'm Greek for my life. I'm half Christolos. Christolos from Samos. Well, my name is Sapolopolous. Serpent Sapolopolous. I'll never forget it. But anyway, thanks for watching. You can make this. Please, please do me a favor. Do not ever use tilapia. Okay, you promise? I see some of you got your fingers like that behind your back. You gotta promise, no tilapias, okay? Anything else, even a carp, okay? That's pretty bad. Mullet, hardheads, but not tilapia. All right, enough of that. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. God bless you. Opa, adios, hasta luego, gloria a Dios, praise the Lord. Bye-bye. Thank you.